Hello friends. Let's talk about gathering. If you like this video, I will talk about many more things on this theme. Today we will talk about the equipment for the gatherer, how it works, what to wear, what skills to choose, which mounts should be chosen based on your budget, and so on. In general, the topic, I think, is clear to you, so let's get started. Equipment. Starting from the fourth tier of gathering, we can use special clothing sets, which increases the harvest of a certain type of resource. The higher the tier of equipment, the more bonuses we get. Also, these bonuses work only in descending order of tiers. That is, if we use tier 7 equipment, it works at the 7th resource tier and below. It will not work on the 8th tier of the resource. The bonus itself increases the chance of getting an additional resource when farming. That is, when we farm, there is a chance that we will receive an additional one resource when collecting. And accordingly, the higher the tier of equipment, the greater the chance of obtaining this additional resource. Gatherer sets also have charm, which increases armor stats, resistance, and health. They do not give any bonuses to the farm. The same goes for quality. Another thing that increases the chance of getting a resource is Avalon tools. They work similarly with the gathering set. Now let's move on to the skills on the clothes of the gather. The head, 90% of the time I use the block. That's 2 seconds of invulnerability. Control doesn't affect you, and you don't get the damage. The block has saved me very often, especially when trying to get into the transition between locations. In some cases, you can choose other skills. For example, if we are in the Reaper set, we can use Pollen, and only if there is an allied territory in the location. Pollen gives you invisibility and introduces control of nearby opponents, which gives you time to get to the territory. The disadvantage of this skill is that it puts you in a state of combat, which is why you can't go between transitions to a location or enter a shelter. Also on the minor cap is the Motivating Worker's Song, which gives you protection from most types of control for 6 seconds. So it fits, too. However, my choice is still a block. The body. There is only one skill for all the gather sets. This is an ambush. 8 seconds of invisibility helps a lot to escape. You can trick the enemy or just temporarily protect yourself from damage. Just be careful with the stalker hood, because he can remove this effect. Legs. In most cases, you can use a unique skill on the miner work boots. Miner, quarryman, harvester, woodcutter, all of them are quite usable. On the fisherman and skinner, I advise you to use a wanderlust or a sprint. Although not everything is so clear with the latest boots, this skill makes the surrounding mobs not aggressive to you, which means you can run deep into the dungeon or into the elite mobs near the world boss, which will also protect you from the crowd of gunkers. We turn to weapons. It serves primarily for the gatherer as an item that increases the chance of survival when hunting him. Many players use different types of weapons, but there are only 2 weapons that are best suited for the gatherer. The first is a double-bladed staff. It has excellent mobility, as well as a health bonus, which makes you even more resilient. Skills should be chosen by the cartwheel, stun run, and of course a soaring swipe to maximize our movement speed. The second weapon is the best in my opinion. It is with him that I farm my whole life. It's a bloodletter. It does not lag far behind the double-bladed staff in mobility, but it does not give such a bonus to health. So why do I use it? There are 2 reasons for this. The first is a free second hand, so we can give various bonuses. The simplest and most popular item is the Mist Collar, which accelerates the recovery of abilities, which makes us more mobile. Next comes the Taproot, which increases health, and the Sacred Scepter, which increases protection from control. The second reason is the damage done. And you may ask, why would I, as a gatherer, do damage? Well, firstly, you kill resource mobs faster, and secondly, sometimes you can kill players as well. Such moments periodically arrive, and thanks to the bloodletting, or rather its ultimate, we can kill inattentive players. Next comes the slot for the cloak. Here, of course, you can use a backpack, which reduces the weight of resources. This way you will be able to put more resources into yourself. However, if we are talking about survival, then there are only two options for cloaks. The first is the cloak of the undead cape, which makes us invisible at 15% of health. It seems to be useful and can save us. However, if the group that ganked us had a bloodletting, we may not live up to this moment, or the effect of the cape will simply be removed by the stalker hood. The second is Ford's Sterling Cape. Protects us from the first control effect. That is, if a mace jumps on us or slows us down, the cloak triggers and dispels this effect. Thus, it saves us from the first incoming control, and in most cases from death altogether, since usually, if we get under the first control, it will be extended further. The advantage of this cloak is that it works, even if we are on a mount, thereby dismounted us will be a very difficult task. Therefore, I recommend using this particular cape. The consumption of the pork pie naturally increases the chance of extracting an additional resource, as well as increases the weight carried. Be sure to use. Also, if we have money, we can buy an upgraded pork pie with higher bonus rates or a Frostpeak Deadeye pie, which, in addition to all the effects, also increases protection from control, that is, stun, deceleration, etc. will last less. Potion. There are only two of them. The first is the invisibility potion. Makes you suddenly invisible, but any damage removes this effect, which is why these potions are not always effective. However, if you break away from the gunkers a little, then such a potion can completely confuse the gunkers and you will outwit your abusers. The second is a protection potion. Temporarily increases resistance to any ingoing damage, and also reduces control actions on you. Easy to use, but it has saved my life more than once. We go further, mounts. Perhaps one of the most important topics of equipment for the gatherer, since your survival rate, movement speed, and earnings depend on them. Choosing the right mount can not only save your life, but also speed up resource extraction at the location. Now we will look at the mounts in increasing cost and efficiency, so that both a beginner and a more experienced player can choose something suitable for themselves. So, the initial levels and the initial capital. Perhaps the undisputed right choice at the beginning of our adventures will be a bull. It is cheap, thick, and has a large carrying weight. But bulls, like bears, give extra weight only when they are called, and if you are in a hurry, and in case you are dismounted, you will be overwhelmed by the weight of the collected resources and will not be able to move. Therefore, I do not recommend using bulls and bears in black or red zones. Let's move on. Giant stag. It will be more expensive, but you will already have an adequate speed of movement, thanks to which you can escape and find valuable resources faster. Starting from the sixth tier of gathering, I would recommend several mounts. The first is a saddled wild boar, which is exactly what is valued because of the nice bonus to carry weight. It is different kinds of boar that give the most extra weight. That's just the same, they work like a bag, and even if you were in a dismounted, you will still move normally without a preponderance. The second is a saddled swamp salamander. The value of salamanders is precisely that they do not have a gallop. Most mounts accelerate over time, salamanders have the same speed all the time, which is why you can easily take damage and not lose your movement speed. And the third, of course, is a moose. In fact, this is an improved version of the giant stag. It is faster, fatter and gives more bonus weight. And already at a high level of gathering, namely on 8th tier, I would single out the 4 best mounts. A spectral dire boar, the same boar, but with steeper parameters, and he also has invisibility. But be careful with all the skills on the mounts, because when using them, we also get a cooldown for this very slot. That is, using invisibility with a cooldown of 50 seconds when dismounting, we also get a cooldown boot on the slot in these same 50 seconds. A gallant horse. The value of this mount lies in an excellent skill, which makes you invulnerable for 4 seconds, which helps a lot against gunkers. But again, the problem is the same, cooldown, which can harm when dismounting. The pest lizard. An excellent mount, has a great constant speed, excellent survival parameters, as well as a very strong skill. This is a poison that disorients opponents. Moreover, it works both passively when attacking you, and you yourself can use it in a certain area. But there is also a minus in this, since when you activate this skill, you enter a state of battle, which is why you cannot move between locations or enter the shelter for 20 seconds. Therefore, this mount will be effective if you collect at a location where there is an allied territory, then this mount will be the best choice. And my favorite mount is the Frost Ram. Good indicators of speed, bonus weight, moderately dense, but his skill is just something. Firstly, it has only 15 seconds to recharge, which is not scary, even if you are in a dismounted. And secondly, the skill itself, if used correctly, can save your life, since during the ram's jump you become invulnerable, which is why you can jump over whole packs of gankers, going to other locations, Avalon, and so on. In my opinion, this mount is the best for the gatherer in the Black Zones. Well, that's it. I hope this guide was useful for novice gatherer. If you want to ask or add something, then welcome to the comments. And also put likes, subscribe, touch the bell. Regaro was with you. All the best and see you again in the vastness, Albion Online.